Hi, my name is George Maciag, and today I'm going to be tying a pattern called George's Killer. This pattern was developed originally by a gentleman named Frank Keim from Kutztown, Pennsylvania. What I've done to it is modernized it a little bit. The original pattern did not have a bead head or any of the flash materials, but it's evolved gradually over the years, and it's become a really popular pattern in the Allentown area. A lot of the local streams like the Little Lehigh, the Big Lehigh, the Saucon, the Monocacy. I have lots of people using it and getting good success with it. All right, now I'm going to show you how to tie one of my killer patterns. This is going to be the gray version. I'm going to start off with this is going to be a size 6, 4X long streamer hook. Typically, I make them in sizes all the way down to as small as 12. But for a size 6, I'm going to take a 3/16 inch gold bead and slip that on. And now I'm going to put some 035 lead wire, 10 turns. I'm just going to take that, put it behind here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And then we're going to take a nail clipper and trim it off. That way you won't ruin your scissors. And now a little bit of super glue in front and jam it in there. And then super glue on the lead. And that'll kind of weld everything all together. So it's really going to be secure. It's not going to slip around. Now I'm going to start with some 140 denier red nylon thread. Where do you find those? I'm going to start right behind the lead wire and cover the shank with the red. Now I'm just going to take some gray squirrel tail and I'm going to cut a hunk of that. And I'm just going to square that off. And butt that right up against the lead. And secure it in. And now I'm just going to tie that off. And now what I do is I just take the scissors and just square off the tail a little bit. And, you know, this, you don't really see this because it's all going to be covered up. But I think that tail helps build up the fly a little bit. And actually, when it's wet, you get a little bit of a squared off tail. Whether it is absolutely necessary, I don't know. Now I'm going to switch thread to a little bit thinner diameter. This is 70 denier. I'm going to just start that. And kind of cover up some of this lead with it. And I'm switching to this thinner thread because I want to get a lot more wraps up here, and I don't want to have the buildup that thicker thread will give me. Back here, I wanted to build it up, so I used a thicker thread. Now I'm going to take 4 of these mallard flank feathers. And we're going to show you later on what I do, but I'm going to tell you, I'm going to wet this using a sponge because the feather becomes much more manageable when it's wet. So I'm going to strip the fluff off and I'm going down to my sponge and I'm wetting the feather. I don't know if you can see this. But you see the contour of that feather. I'm going to use 4 feathers, 1 on the bottom, 1 on the top, and 1 on each side. And I always want the curvature, have a concave area facing the shank. So what I do initially is start on the bottom, take that feather and just kind of slide it in here. And secure it with about 10 or 12 good firm wraps. Once again, using the fingernail clippers, I think a fingernail clipper is a really good idea with bead heads because the curvature of the clippers matches the curvature of the bead, so you can just slip it in and trim that right off with no problem at all. Now we're gonna flip it back around, and I'm gonna take a second mallard flank feather, strip off the fluff, wet it up so I get that nice curvature. And I'm just gonna lay that right on top. And again, secure it with a few good firm wraps. Trim with the clippers. And now, take another feather. And this feather I'm gonna put on the far side of the hook. And notice how I'm constantly stroking and working the feathers. I want to achieve like a bullet shape. And that's looking pretty good. Trim that off. One more flank feather to go. And as I said, you can make, I also make this with these mallard flank feathers dyed brown, and you can get them in a whole host of colors. Those are the two colors I use most often. Final feather on the near side. Now I'm using pretty much maximum tension here because I don't, a lot of people that try to tie this fly, they complain that the feathers pull out. And you have to use really maximum tension at this point. And if you do that, it's not going to be a problem. Okay, the next we're going to do is add a little bit of flash. I'm going to take two strands of pearl crystal flash. I'm going to just fold it around the string. And then just slide it down. And trim it off. Well, a little shorter than the feather. And then the remaining piece, I'm going to just fold that around the thread again. Bring that up on the near side.
Next is parked at the front entryway. The side rack is not a parking spot. Please move the car.
And now, I'm just going to put a bunch more wraps on here to cover up all the remnants of the flash material. And then finally, whip finish. Trim off. And I'm gonna take a little head lacquer. Eventually, I'm going to take some yellow paint with a dowel and put that on top of the red. And when that's dry, I take a smaller dowel and put the pupil of the eye in using black paint. And then finally, I give it a top coat of lacquer to keep the paint from chipping off. So that's the final example of George's Killer and how to tie it.